Boys, real quick, UFC 266 is tomorrow night. We got a needle mover. We got a needle mover on the card. Nick Diaz is returning. That's the older brother of Nate Diaz, the guy who fought Conor McGregor, Warrior, you know, he fought Masvidal, he fought everybody. He's fighting Robbie Lawler, which makes this a little bit strange because these two fellas fought in 2004. In the UFC, when they were both very young coming up, Robbie Lawler was a knockout, vicious knockout artist, and Nick Diaz knocked Lawler out and finished him. Now, they went on to have their careers, great careers, and Nick Diaz hasn't fought since 2015, January of 2015, so you're talking over 6 years. It's crazy. I'll get back to that. Robbie Lawler has been in a steady decline of late. Great fighter, not taking anything away from him, but Robbie Lawler has been a stepping stone lately for other fighters like Colby Covington, who really whooped his ass all night. Like, you know, like, Robbie Lawler's not, he hasn't been beating anybody lately, like, that I could think of note. It's not in my mind. If it's not catching your mind like that, then you, the instincts, you're probably right. Robbie Lawler's on the decline. So here's what I want to see. All right, first of all, that fight is third from main. You got the main event, Volkanovski Ortega. Then you got Shevchenko, the Eastern European woman that's just dominating everybody. I'm not even really going over that fight. She just dominates everybody. She's minus 1,600. So obviously they expect you to do the same thing. So it's basically Volkanovski and Ortega and Nick Diaz and Robbie Lawler. They made, now the Nick Diaz, Robbie Lawler is third from main. So you got that one, Shevchenko, Valentina, and then the main. So they, I noticed every UFC fight that is not a title fight is always three rounds. They made it a five round fight because the Diaz brothers are known for their cardio. Now, who is Nick Diaz? Nick Diaz is the one who started the Diaz army. He started this whole thing with, you know, and then his brother exploded later and got popular. But Nick Diaz is a hell of a fighter. But here's the thing. I don't know if I'm going to see that same guy in the ring. You're going to see one of two guys. You're going to know it early. You might see a Nick Diaz that has no more reflexes, and he's been in wars. Once a guy gets hit a couple thousand times or whatever it takes for that guy, everybody's different. Sometimes you're never the same. I don't know what kind of guy we're going to see. What's he, about 37? He's lived a hard life a little bit too in between. I don't know. So I'm hoping to see the guy that's going to be at that same pace, be there all night, and fight a great fight with Robbie Lawler. I want to see a 3 to 5 round fight. I think if the fight ends early, it'll be Lawler knocking Diaz out or something crazy, like he's just a shell of himself. So it's tricky. That one's a fun one to watch. So if you're gonna spend the money and order it, you got a good one, and you got Curtis Blaydes, a fun heavyweight, fourth from Maine. So right from four, there's only five on the main card. Right from the fourth one that I noticed is fun, Curtis Blaydes, heavyweight. Then you got Diaz Lawler. Now, Lawler is a slight favorite. Diaz hasn't fought in forever. I wouldn't bet that fight. Fighting's hard enough to bet. I would not bet that fight at all. Just watch it and have fun. See these two rematch. Diaz says he feels like he could kick the shit out of Kamaru Usman, the champ at 170. So let's see if Nick Diaz, here's the starting point. Let's see tomorrow night, Nick Diaz, if he can still fight, if he still has something, if he's still him, he should beat Robbie Lawler. Because I know Lawler's on the decline. I don't know about Nick Diaz. That's the unknown because nobody's seen him. He hasn't been in the octagon. So we got to see. Moving up to the main event. Alexander Volkanovski. Oh my God. If you guys don't know about this guy, he's the 145-pound champion. He used to be a rugby player, okay? His heaviest weight he ever was, He was 214 pounds. This little guy's got a ton of cardio. He weighed in at 144.5 pounds today for the title fight tomorrow. He fights at 145. He used to be 214. He's so much stronger than everybody in the division. He's the champ right now, and nobody's been able to dethrone him. He had a good fight with Max Holloway, great fight, but he won. And he looks like he is the most durable, toughest, and to be a rugby player, you got to have a certain mind. Oh, man, he's fighting Brian Ortega. I like Brian Ortega a lot. Now, here's why I always make fun of Conor McGregor. Like, ooh, how do I look at my channel? Like, pipe down, little man. Weight classes mean a lot. Brian Ortega fought at 145 for a while, did great. He moved up, like, briefly, and then went into a war and got smoked by somebody. I remember it was a bad fight. Ortega went up, and now he's back down to 145 because that's his best division. McGregor, you should be taking notes. You should be back down. But Ortega's a game fighter. He just beat the Korean Zombie. He's a free-flowing guy. Up, down, jiu-jitsu. He's got it all. But it's going to be a tough, tough task to beat Alexander Volkanovski. That little guy, guys, if you haven't seen him, he's powerful. He just doesn't stop. He's a tremendous pace. But Ortega's got a lot of heart. If you know, if you've been watching Ortega for a couple years, he's got a lot of heart. So he's not just going to lay down. So I expect to see a good fight and maybe something I might even order. I'm not allowed to do the fight companion because I'm not monetized yet. I have to have my 1,000 subscribers and my 4,000 hours and all that stuff. So guys, like, subscribe. Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. So when there's a UFC fight going on in the future, you don't have to order it. I'll do the play-by-play, and I'll tell you exactly what's going on, and we could have a lot of fun. But I didn't realize you have to like hit certain levels. So subscribe, spread it to a friend, and I'll see you soon.